Some of the best street food I've ever eaten was in Asia. Every one of those little markets was filled with smells of delicious food that all centered around an Asian staple, noodles. Learn to cook those properly, and you'll be surprised how quick and easy it is to knock off a delicious dinner. First off, we're gonna soak our noodles. Now, these are rice noodles into a bowl, and just pour the hot water over the rice noodles. Soak and rehydrate. 12 to 15 minutes to soften up. If you've got a wok, perfect. If not, just a normal size frying pan with big sloping sides. Pan on. Get it really nice and hot. Chicken breast, very lean, hardly any fat. On there, you've got this little fillet. Just slice that off. Now, the secret to getting it really nice and thin and to cut it into strips. Take your knife, keep it nice and flat on the board and sort of slice it in half, like a sort of scallop, like that. We call this butterflying the chicken. Take a rolling pin and nice and gently roll over the chicken. What it does, it sort of flattens it, allows you to slice it even thinner. And the thinner the slice of the chicken, the sort of crispier it gets, the quicker it cooks. Slice it in half. Start slicing these nice thin slices. And the good news is one chicken breast can serve two or three easily.
Next, wash your knife and finely slice garlic.
The thinner the garlic, the crispier. This is a young, tender broccoli. Just slice them down. I want a bite to the broccoli. And normally you sort of paste the dish with one third noodles, one third vegetables, and one third of your protein, chicken. With a dish that takes literally minutes to put together, it's really important to get everything organized. Everything needs to be at your fingertips. Touch of olive oil. Get that pan really nice and ready. Just starting to smoke. Drop the chicken in first. Touch of salt, pepper. Open up those little strands of chicken. Nice. Once you've started to sear off the chicken, get the garlic in. Now, let that get really nice and crispy. And the way to do it is to sort of spread all the chicken, the garlic, up the side of the pan. You see why it's so important to cut the chicken into thin strips, because it colours and cooks at the same time as well. Really, really crucial. Now that garlic's getting really nice and crispy. Broccoli in. Feels strange putting raw broccoli in like that. Normally, we blanch it in boiling water, dry it out, but you want that crunch. Now, soy sauce. That helps to season it, but also stains beautifully. Soy sauce in. Lovely. That's exactly what I want. Now take that out. Give your pan a little wipe out. A little teaspoon of olive oil. Get that wok really nicely oiled again. Drain your noodles. They're beautiful. This is a really exciting way of finishing this quick stir fry. Very classic. Two eggs in. Whisk up the eggs. Give that a really good whisk. Sort of almost spread it at the side of the pan. Lightly season the eggs, noodles in, chicken and broccoli in. And give that a really nice mix. You want the egg to sort of almost bring the dish together. That egg's cooked. Make sure you got that nice, even distribution of chicken, broccoli, garlic. Lovely. And then just finish that fresh lime. And there you have a very simple, delicious stir fry with rice noodles. Making your gnocchi is so simple to do, yet the results are absolutely stunning. And it's a great way of using up leftover baked potatoes. You can make gnocchi just with flour and eggs. However, the potato gives it that nice, light, sort of creamy, fluffy texture. Just cut them in half. Take your spoon and scoop the inside of those potatoes.
I'm using leftover baked potatoes, but this really works as well with leftover boiled potatoes.
Two choices. You can get a fork and sort of mash the potato and get it nice and light and fluffy. Or this little gadget, it's called a ricer. I suppose it's a posh word for a potato masher. Just squeeze gently. You can see how nice and light it is. Almost like fluffy little strands of potato. You can do this when the potatoes are hot. It'll go through the ricer so much quicker. Just slice that off there. Now, a nice spoon of ricotta in. A little touch of salt and pepper. It's really important to season the mixture as we go along, otherwise the gnocchi becomes really bland. Flour over the ricotta. Sieved, so there's no lumps. One delicious egg. Give that a little whisk. Now, make a little well in the centre. You want a nice, soft, pliable ball of dough. Give that a really good mix. Get some thyme flowers in there. And this thyme is light, fragrant, and it's just a really nice herb. And with the ricotta, it tastes brilliant. Just pick the little tips of the thyme flowers.
Next, flour your hands generously and knead the mixture into a dough.
Fold in and push. And basically what it's doing is getting it nice and smooth. As it starts to get a little bit wet, and just add a little touch of flour. But we want something really nice and soft. Now don't overwork it. It stops the gnocchi from expanding when it hits the pan. That's exactly what I want. A nice sort of soft, fragrant ball. Cut the ball in half. Lightly flour the hands and just roll it gently. And just think of a big, long cigar. The mixture will start getting a little bit sort of wetter, but do not add lots of flour. Now, lightly flour the knife. So when you slice the gnocchi, it doesn't stick.
Cut the dough into bite-sized pieces.
Just take your finger, dip it in the flour, and push down. Why? I want my gnocchi to look like a pillow. And for me, the most important part there is that not one of them are identically the same shape. Water on. Bring it up to the boil. A little touch of olive oil in there. Lightly flour your hand. Lift up the gnocchi. In to the rolling boiling water. Turn that pan to stop them from sticking at the bottom and let them simmer. And they start to sort of tell you they're cooked when they start floating. Get a pan on, get that nice and hot. Now they're just starting to come up to the top and you can continue cooking them like that. I like blanching them in the water, taking them out and then frying them.
To study the gnocchi, heat olive oil in a frying pan.
Gently lift up and look, they've doubled in size. Drain it, get rid of the excess water and straight in to the hot pan. This is where they start to take on a completely different texture. Nice crisp, sauteed texture on the outside. Gnocchi loves fresh pepper. So, pepper in. And you'll see, as I start turning them, I've got this really nice little sort of brown colour. And they're almost puffing up now, like little parcels. So I want them nice and sauteed, both sides, but light and creamy in the centre. Fresh garden peas in. And the butter gives it that really nice sort of beurre noisette flavour on the end. Beautiful. Put a little bit of fresh thyme over the peas. And then finally, I want to lift it up. Fresh lemon. Zest the lemon over. So, smells incredible. And then finally, seal the deal with a touch of grated Parmesan cheese.
Give your veg some attitude, and you'll get amazingly elegant dishes on a budget that are always guaranteed to impress. What more do you want from great cooking? Cheap to make, easy to cook, and absolutely stunning.
For me, food always has to be impressive. But when it comes to desserts, often you see sponge sugar or wild decorations. Remember, simple is always the most impressive. This cheesecake is so straightforward, yet so delicious. Now, cream cheese, leave it out of the fridge for 5 or 10 minutes. Go nice and soft. Trust me, your arms will be thanking you. Sugar in. This cheesecake is New York cheesecake because it's baked. So there's no base. Start creaming the cheese and the sugar. Spending the amount of time I do in the States, if there's one thing they know how to do out there, is the most amazing, impressive cheesecake. Rich, delicious, but so simple. Work the bowl. Lift the bowl to your advantage. Really whisk. Whisk, whisk, whisk. Lovely. Nice and creamy. Now, get your eggs.
Add the eggs to the mixture, bit by bit. Doing it this way, it's more efficient.
A, you're incorporating a lot of air. B, the mixture doesn't separate. The last little of your egg. Lovely. Of course, you can use an electric mixer, but why go to the gym when you can just make a cheesecake a day? A cheesecake a day. Keep the bingo wings away. Now, a couple of tablespoons of flour. Give it a whisk. Stops it from going lumpy. Now, I want to scent that cheesecake. I've got the freshness, the zest of the lemon in there. I want to sort of tart it up even more. Fold in some fresh raspberries. So just mix them through. Be careful not to crush them.
Then grease a cake tin with butter. This will ensure your cheesecake slides out beautifully.
Get your mix. Let that fall in. Now take your cake tin and just tap it. The mixture hits the bottom of the cake tin. The raspberries rise and you've got raspberries at the top, the middle and the bottom. And it also stops all those little pockets of air trapping underneath the mixture in the cake tin. So there's no holes in the cheesecake. Now into the oven, 180 degrees for 35 to 40 minutes. Slightly souffled up. Pull off. That's the colour I wanted on top. And look at it. It's one of the simplest, yet the most stylish cheesecakes anywhere. Beautiful.